Assalamu alaikum doctors. Now let's talk about the infectious diseases of the liver. Now what is viral hepatitis? So hepatitis is a general term which means that there is inflammation of the liver. Now there are certain group of viruses which are responsible for causing infection in the liver exclusively, and that viruses is called hepatotrophic viruses. What are hepatotrophic viruses? Hepatotrophic viruses are the group of viruses which are responsible for causing infection in the liver primarily, and they have a specific affinity toward the liver. So in this category, we have a hepatitis A virus, hepatitis B virus, hepatitis C virus, and hepatitis D and hepatitis E virus. These viruses are termed as hepatotrophic viruses because they have a specific affinity toward the liver and it causes infection in the liver exclusively. While in another category, we have a certain group of viruses which are not causing infection in the liver primarily, but it can cause infection in the liver secondarily, and that are called as cytomegalovirus and Epstein-Barr virus. So it can cause viral infection. It can cause viral hepatitis, but they are not termed as hepatotrophic viruses. Now let's talk about the hepatitis A virus. Now hepatitis A virus belongs to picornavirus family. Hepatitis A virus is RNA virus. Remember students that all hepatotrophic viruses, they are RNA viruses except hepatitis B viruses, which are DNA virus. Now let's talk about the incubation period. The incubation period of hepatitis A, that is range from 2 to 6 weeks. Incubation period means from the beginning of infection till the symptoms appearance. So that is 2 to 6 weeks for the hepatitis A virus. Well, the most important point regarding the hepatitis A virus is that hepatitis A virus, it causes acute infection of the liver. But in certain cases, it is being reported that in 0.1% it can lead to the fulminant hepatitis. So the hepatitis A virus causes acute infection, but in 0.1% it is being reported that it can cause fulminant hepatitis. Now, what are the clinical features? If a patient is suffering from the hepatitis A viral infection, so there will be non-specific symptoms of the patients, like there will be fever, there will be jaundice due to the retention of bilirubin, and there will be loss of appetite, and along with that there will be vomiting. And why vomiting? Because liver is enlarged to such a way that it encroaches on the stomach and esophagus, so there will be vomiting as well. And along with that, all the serum transaminases level like ALT and AST, it get raised from their normal value. So ALT and AST is also raised from the normal value. Now let's talk about the mode of transmission. So it is transmitted by ingestion of contaminated water and food, and fecal-oral route transmission. And with close contact with infected person. It is also acquired by travelers. And if the patient starts symptoms like symptoms appearance of infected person. Now, infected person getting started symptoms. So before 2 to 3 weeks of these symptoms, and after 1 week of these symptoms, the hepatitis A virus, it will shed and stool and urine. So this is a very high yield point. You don't need to forget this point. It is very important. Now, how this hepatitis A virus is getting transmitted? By ingestion of contaminated water and food, by fecal oral route transmission, with close contact with infected person, and acquired by travelers. And whenever this infected person getting started symptoms, so before 2 to 3 weeks of getting starting symptoms, and after 1 week of this symptoms appearance, this hepatitis A virus should in stool and urine. This is very important point. Now let's talk about the last, that is pathogenesis of the hepatitis A virus. That actually how this hepatitis A virus, it causes acute liver infection and lead to acute hepatitis. Now say this is a hepatitis A virus. If this is a hepatitis A virus, and when it getting started, infected the hepatocytes, infected hepatocytes. So what happens that say this is a hepatocytes. If this is a hepatocytes, so in the hepatocytes, the lipid membrane, the cell membrane is also lipid bilayer. So there will be lipid bilayer. So there will be lipid bilayer. Now in the cell membrane of this hepatocytes, there is some specific proteins is present in this cell membrane. Okay, there is some important protein seated in the cell membrane of this hepatocytes. Now this protein, it has a special carbohydrate chains. And this special carbohydrate chain is called glycoproteins. And that glycoprotein is called hepatitis A virus CR1. Now, so there is special proteins, and this protein have a special carbohydrate chain, and this is called hepatitis A virus CR1. Actually, it is a glycoprotein, and it act as a receptor for hepatitis A virus. Okay, say if it is a hepatitis A virus, so hepatitis A virus causing infection of hepatocytes, so initially it will bind to this receptors. And that receptor is hepatitis A virus CR1. So when it get bind to this, it is able to coming inside into the cell, and it cause hepatocytes disruption. So that is the general pathogenesis, actually how this hepatitis A virus causing infection. Now whenever it cause infection, this hepatitis A virus cause infection, so our body recognize it as a foreign antigen. And it is very obvious, whenever antigen is getting enter into the body, so our body recognize it as a foreign antigen, and our body start making antibodies against those antigen. So in this case, our body make antibodies in the form of IgM. So our body making IgM against the hepatitis A virus. So after a few months, the titer of IgM, it getting start decreasing. So instead of IgM, then IgG antibodies produced by our body, and then this antibody, it persists lifelong, but not it is clinically possible. Okay, so that's the general pathogenesis of the hepatitis A virus, actually how it causes infection. Hopefully you get the lecture. Thank you so much.